What's going on? Back again with another video, but we're gonna get straight into this joint, you know what I'm saying? I hope, you know what I'm saying, the previous, top 10 list I did, you know what I'm saying? I hope y'all enjoyed it. I hope y'all actually checked out some of the artists, and you know what I'm saying? Some made it to the playlist, some didn't, or it just made you, you know what I'm saying, kind of like, appreciate, you know what I'm saying, what these guys were doing, obviously. And, this time, I came with another top 10 list, and this list is called Top 10 Storytelling Raps of All Time. And obviously, of all time is always debatable, you know what I'm saying? And so, I just want to put this disclaimer out again that this is my personal top 10 storytelling raps of all time. You know what I'm saying? Some of these songs might not be in your list, you know what I'm saying? But it is for me, obviously. And what do I, like, what is the metric? How am I measuring this? You know what I'm saying? How, why is a song or an artist on this, you know what I'm saying, list? Is because it's not just the fact that how good a story is. Obviously, that has a huge, you know what I'm saying, element, you know what I'm saying, in me picking why this, you know what I'm saying, in me picking the song for this list, you know what I'm saying. So how good a story is, but it's not just how good a story is, it's how the rapper conveys it, you know what I'm saying. What type of literary, you know what I'm saying, devices is he using? How, you know what I'm saying, what type of metaphor, symbolism is there, you know what I'm saying? Like, what type of, like, lesson and the moral of the story is at the end, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's so many things that go on, like, and how, like, you know what I'm saying, the way he rhymes in the song, you know what I'm saying, the way he does it so effortlessly while, you know what I'm saying, unfolding the story as well, you know what I'm saying, all together. So, like, this is the, you know what I'm saying, the art of storytelling in rap is a very difficult talent. A very, very difficult time to do it effectively. I'm sure there's a lot of rappers out there who want to do it, you know what I'm saying? But it's different from the jump, from the way you write to the way you deliver it. Like, it's almost like writing a book, but you have to do it in this concise form where you gotta introduce your characters, you gotta, you know what I'm saying, talk about all this and come to a climax and an ending to it, you know what I'm saying? All in a song, on a beat, while you rhyme, you know what I'm saying? So this talent, you know what I'm saying? So it is a crazy talent to have. And you know what I'm saying, these are the top 10 songs that I have picked, you know what I'm saying, that I think is the best of all time, you know what I'm saying? So, if you're ready, let's go! Number 10, Slick Rick's Children's Story. Once upon a time, not long ago, when people wore pajamas and lived life slow. Children's Story is Slick Rick's classic cautionary tale for children. He tells the story of two kids who decide to start robbing people. One of the kids become addicted and can't stop. One day he robs an undercover detective. After a long chase with the cops, he is shot dead. Slick Rick made a name for himself with an amazing flow and storytelling abilities during the 80s and the 90s. And most of the GOATs you know of today, such as Eminem or Snoop Dogg, were all heavily influenced by Slick Rick. So I definitely advise you guys to check out this song, it is super dope. Boy was strapped. The kid pulled out a gun, he said, "Why hit me?" The barrel set straight for the cop's kidney. Number 9, Kendrick Lamar's Keisha song. Keisha's song is a story inspired by one of Kendrick Lamar's friends who had resorted to prostitution at a young age. It's a song about the struggle and pain women go through who have to resort to prostitution. Also, it's a song for his little sister, instructing her through a narrative tragedy to never resort to selling her own body. Moreover, he wants his sister to see the woman behind the prostitute, so to speak. Kendrick Lamar uses his language purposefully and efficiently to communicate his message to his audience. His vulgar and graphic imageries and language is juxtaposed with themes of fragility and brokenness, which reinforce his main message of protecting women in the song. Usuals leaving her body sore. She take the little change she make to fix her nail cuticles. Lipstick is suitable to make you fiend for more. Number 8, Outkast, The Art of Storytelling Part 1. Somebody hit me the other day for a rendezvous. Was it the Winch that cut the good and the dungeon crew? Let's say her name was Susie Screw, cause she screwed a lot. The Art of Storytelling Part 1 is a song from Outkast, a duo consisting of Andre 3000 and Big Boi. This song sees Big Boi and Andre reeling two distinct experiences. Big Boi dealing with a promiscuous woman he encountered named Susie Screw, Screw is the keyword, and Andre telling a tragic tale about a girl with a drug addiction, Sasha Thumper, and Thumper being the keyword. Thumper is another term for a heroin addict, if you guys didn't know. What is most remarkable about this song is the humanization of both Andre and Big Boi's characters, a pregnant drug addict and a promiscuous woman who universally would be degraded in the mass media and in political commentary. Fun fact, J. Cole used the song's beat for his song, Land of the Snakes. And another fun fact, you know what I'm saying, about this song is the cadence Andre, you know what I'm saying, ends his last verse here is the same cadence Kendrick ends his last verse on Keisha's song. And both of them are telling a very similar story about two very similar characters, you know what I'm saying, with a tragic life. You could kind of like see Kendrick Lamar, you know what I'm saying, paying homage to Andre 3000, you know what I'm saying, in this, if, you know what I'm saying, if you want to look at it that way. Number 7, Joyner Lucas, Ross Cappuccioni.
Woke up at 7, my day see more than I pray for. Got dressed to head out and ride to school on my skateboard.
This song is based on a true story of a 17-year-old, Ross Cappuccioni, who survived multiple gunshots by one of his close friends as part of a gang initiation. Joyner Lucas's ability to recount the story from both sides while depicting the chilling chain of events leading up to the climax is storytelling on an expert level. There is a real-life video about this story on YouTube, as well as an amazing music video that narrates the story perfectly, so go check it out.
My name is Ross Cappuccioni. I'm from Macomb, Michigan. There was a fence, like a grass area, my vehicle, and then houses right there. So it was like, I wasn't in the middle of nowhere or anything. And like I get out, and he gets out, and like, it's only a couple seconds, I'm looking around.
Number 6, Nas, I Gave You Power.
I seen some cold nights and bloody days. They grabbed me in bullet spray. They used me wrong, so I sing this song to this day.
Nas is known for some of the most innovative ideas in hip-hop, and I Gave You Power was an early example that Nas was an MC who not only had something to say, but found intriguing ways to get his message across. As J. Cole says in one of his songs, Pac was like Jesus, Nas wrote the Bible. I Gave You Power is considered to be one of Nas' biggest hit songs, as well as a hip-hop classic. The song's lyrics is a first-person narrative from a perspective of an illegal handgun, so he's basically talking as if he's a gun and the vicious cycle he goes through. This is personification at its finest, and Nas uses this literary device impeccably to reflect on the upbringing and the kind of violence he went through growing up in Brooklyn.
Always I'm in some shit. My abdomen is the clip. The barrel's my dick. Uncircumcised, pull my skin back and cop me. I bust off when they unlock me.
Number 5, Tupac Shakur's Brenda's Got a Baby.
I hear Brenda's got a baby, but Brenda's barely got a brain. A damn shame, the girl can hardly spell her name.
Brenda's Got a Baby is the second single off of Tupac Shakur's debut album, Tupacalypse Now. Brenda's Got a Baby is a song about a 12-year-old who lives in the ghettos with a baby she cannot support. Through the narrative lens of an abused young girl, Tupac addresses teen pregnancy, ineffective welfare, and the weak family structure rotting the ghetto. At this time, no male rapper had ever before narrated the problems young women were facing in poverty-stricken communities, which makes the song such a powerful political statement. Tupac was a revolutionary, an artist, and a visionary who really was well ahead of his time.
She's 12 years old and she's having a baby. In love with the molester who's sex and a crazy.
Number 4, Jedi Mind Tricks featuring R.A. the Rugged Man, Uncommon Valor, The Vietnam Story.
Call me Thorburn, John A. Stab Sergeant, Marksman, skillin', killin', illin', I'm able and willing, kill a village elephant, raping and pillage a village.
Uncommon Valor, The Vietnam Story is a song from the hip-hop duo Jedi Mind Tricks, consisting of rapper Vinny Paz and producer Stu. Vinny Paz provides the opening verse, giving a first-person narrative of a young and scared American soldier in Giai Dinh, Vietnam. He sees the corruption of the army and the carnage of the battles and starts to question the real motive behind their occupation. Ari the Rugged Man's verse recounts the real war experience of his father. Ari's father is the highly decorated war hero, Staff Sergeant John A. Thorburn, who was nearly killed in a crash near Cambodia after his helicopter's pilot was shot. Many see Ari's verse in the song as one of the best written verses in hip-hop, and personally, I will put this feature and his verse in the top 10 best written verses of all time in hip-hop. The writing, to the rhymes, to the unfolding of the story, to its exposition and its ending, it's an experience you cannot miss.
Cambodia right in the enemy hand. Take a swig of the whiskey to calm us. Them yellow men wearing black pajamas, they wanna harm us.
Number 3, Immortal Techniques, You Never Know. Immortal Technique is an underground rapper most known for his music that touches on topics such as class struggle, poverty, religion, and imperialism. So when he came out with You Never Know, a song in the album Revolutionary Volume 2, it was a bit of a surprise as he expresses his vulnerable side. This song is a beautiful illustration of a pure love which brews between Immortal Technique and a female love interest. The girl proves to be hard to get, not because she's stuck up or uninterested, but because she has a deeper story to tell. This song has twists and turns that will leave you at the edge of your seat. You would need a box of tissues for this one.
To the average kid, the type of Latina I'd sit and contemplate marriage with. Fuck the horse and carriage shit, her love was never for hire.
Number 2, Eminem's Stan.
Dear Slim, I wrote you but you still ain't calling. I left my cell, my pager and my home phone at the bottom.
As we all know by now, Eminem is a poet that has a profound understanding of the power of language. However, there is no other song that has done more to reaffirm this fact than this song here, Stan. Stan is a story about an obsessive fan who kills himself and his girlfriend because his idol, Eminem, never writes back, and he introduces one of the album's key themes, the scary power of fame. Eminem articulates a brand of sensationalism and celebrity worship we now take as normal. He plays both sides of the coin, being the obsessive fan and Slim Shady. Eminem's ability to narrate while sliding in and out of rhymes effortlessly while showing off his lyrical depth and emotional range has enabled him to hit a cultural milestone with this one. The word Stan is also now an official word in the dictionary.
Well, gotta go. I'm almost at the bridge now. Oh, I forgot. How am I supposed to send it out?
Number 1. Immortal Techniques, Dance with the Devil. Dance with the Devil by Immortal Technique easily takes the number 1 spot for me in this list. If you have 7 minutes, do yourself a favor and please just listen to it once. It will change your life and perspective in so many ways. However, disclaimer, it is not for the faint-hearted. It is dark, graphic, fiendish, yet remarkable in how Immortal Technique delivers and unfolds the story. It is a tale of a young boy, Billy Jacobs, who is blinded by the glamour and illusion of gang life as it ends in a disturbing twist. This is the epitome of storytelling rap. The way Immortal Technique sets the tone and stage, introduces the characters, builds the tempo, and progresses the story, whilst at the same time having the listeners fully engaged till the end, is truly remarkable. If you're a true hip-hop fan, this is a cult classic you cannot skip.
Reputation, cause he could hustle and steal, but got locked once and didn't hesitate to squeal. So criminals he chilled with didn't think he was real.
And man, that is it, you know what I'm saying, for the top 10 list today. You know what I'm saying? I hope y'all enjoyed the list. You know what I'm saying? I hope you guys obviously go and, you know what I'm saying, listen to the songs. And I know that, you know what I'm saying, not all of these songs and, you know what I'm saying, these artists will be in your playlist or something that is your style or something that you want to listen to every day. Obviously not, because it's super dense, you know what I'm saying? It's super it's super heavy too, you know what I'm saying, at times. So, but this is, you know what I'm saying, something that I think you guys should definitely listen to, you know what I'm saying, kind of like know the evolution of storytelling rap, or, you know what I'm saying, like how it evolved, or how these people take the English language, you know what I'm saying, or just take language in general and depict stories, and, you know what I'm saying, just rhymes in there and symbolism and metaphors and the morals of the story, you know what I'm saying. Like, it's so intriguing. And as a hip-hop fan, I believe, you know what I'm saying, some, like, at least half of these songs in this list, you know what I'm saying, I'm sure you guys have already listened to already, you know what I'm saying. But I think it is something that, you know what I'm saying, would be super dope if you guys could, you know what I'm saying, take your time, you know what I'm saying, to kind of like go into these songs and the artists, you know what I'm saying, and kind of see where all these things came about. So anyway, man, I hope, you know what I'm saying, this has been fun for you guys as well as it has been for me. I hope you guys go check it out, you know what I'm saying, keep liking, subscribing, you know, and all that. And obviously, you know what I'm saying, hit the notification bell or whatever that shit is, you know what I'm saying, as well, you know what I'm saying. I think this is it for today, man. Thank y'all for watching, man. We